So, you know, the unemployment's at 3.6%. Wage growth is pretty good. You know, the indicators right now for interest rates going down is usually a benefit for the REIT industry. So, so far this year, first quarter, as you just said, 16% up. So the market seems pretty good for the REIT industry.
Have you seen, though, any signs of the economy slowing down a little bit, as we've seen with some pockets of data in the last few months?
So, again, being focused on retail, you tend to see that pretty immediately. So far, we haven't seen that. Retail sales overall has been up. And effectively, if you look at restaurant sales, which is usually the lead indicator, they seem to be going up. So far, we haven't seen the consumer pull back at all.
And yet, 7,100 store closures have been announced by U.S. retailers so far in 2019. How are you dealing with that?
The good news is double that probably are opening, right? So if you actually think about there are winners and losers in every market, and the reason we all are in business is because of the winners. And effectively, from our perspective, this year happens to be our greatest leasing year ever. So effectively, digitally native brands, brands that are actually growing, more than compensate for the stores that are closing.
The standard story for a while now about physical retail has been that the top quality shopping centers and malls will be fine, and that more malls are being made into social hubs of some sort or another, right? Gathering places, movie theaters, activities. Where are we in that process? First of all, do you buy into those things?
So we bought into that many years ago. You know, I ran CEO of GGP before Brookfield bought us over. And so we made a decision early in the game to focus on the best retail real estate. And so we see that bifurcation occurring. The best retail real estate is actually growing rapidly, almost 4 or 5% a year, which is pretty healthy for real estate. And the lower quality assets are going away. But that's been the case for over 20 years,
yeah.
Right? So basically, as I like to say, we're under-demolished more than anything else. And so effectively, the best quality real estate, it continues to densify, continues to add entertainment, continues to curate correctly. And I think we're early in the game for that process. But I think it's going in the right direction.
Who's growing the fastest? Who's doing the most leasing? You said you're having a good year. Who's driving it?
From retailers' perspective, you've got the digitally native people, such as UNTUCKit, Warby Parker, who are Casper, which are all grown and incubated online, are growing in bricks and mortar format. You've got the entertainment uses, which is Dave & Buster's and Main Event and Round One, growing rapidly. You've got, you know, fitness, which is Lifetime Fitness, Equinox, HoldCycle, and the like, growing rapidly. So you've got plenty of players, you know, that are what I call what millennials want today, experiences that are growing within the best retail real estate in the country.